In this video, we'll be discussing the best credit cards of 2021. We'll be breaking everything down from the credit card with the high sign-up bonus, the credit cards that's good for everyday use, credit cards that you should apply for if you have no credits, or credit cards that you should apply for when you have really bad credits, when you don't think you can be accepted to any credit cards at all. Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Kevin Noh. And before we get any further, please drop a like down below and hit the subscribe button, please. And watch until the end as I'll be disclosing my first ever credit card. Without further ado, let's start off with the credit card that you should apply for if you have really bad credits. This means you filed bankruptcy before. This means you missed payments before. This is the credit card that you should apply for if you can't get accepted to any other credit cards. This credit card is the Discover is Care card. The reason why this credit card is so amazing and the reason why I recommend this credit card to you is because this card has no annual fee, 2% cash back at all gas stations and restaurants on up to $1,000 per quarter. 1% cash back on all purchases, and along with that, Discover will double your cash back at the end of the first year. So if you earn $150 in cash back at the end of your first year, they'll double that, and now you have a total of $300 in cash back. So the good and the bad things about this card is that it's a really great card to build your credit score, as they will report your credit history to the top three major credit bureaus. And the not so good thing about this card is that your credit limit is dependable on your security deposit, and it starts out at a minimum of $200. So your security deposit needs to be at least $200. Coming back to the good side of this card is that your security deposit is refundable and they will give it back to you. This first credit card is a really simple credit card, as it is meant for people who are rebuilding their credit score or have no credit score at all. The people who want to apply for this card are the people who have no credit history and can't get accepted to any other cards. Because of the security deposit is why this is a great first card, and because of that, most people who apply for this card will most likely get accepted. Now we just talk about what card you should apply for if your credit score is damaged or if it isn't good at all. Now we'll talk about a really good credit card, a credit card that I have, a credit card that you can apply for and most likely get accepted, even if you have no credit history, even if you have no credit score at all. It is the Bank of America Cash Rewards credit card. So this credit card has a sign-up bonus. When you first spend your first $1,000 within the first 3 months, they'll give you $200 in cash back. On top of that, this credit card has 1% cash back on all purchases, 2% cash back on grocery stores, and 3% cash back on a category of your choice. The category ranges from travel, restaurants, online shopping, and many, many more. And to add it all up, this credit card also has no annual fee. So it is a really great credit card. So if you can get accepted to this card, I would recommend applying to this card rather than the previous one, the Discover Secure card. So as mentioned earlier, this card gives you 3% cash back on a category of your choice. But what I didn't mention is that you only limit it up to $2,500 each quarter. Similar to the Discover Secure card, that card was limited to $1,000 per quarter. This card is limited to $2,500 per quarter. But the good thing about it and the trick to get over this is that you can apply for as many of these cards as you want. Even though you already have one, you can apply for another one. Just like I have this one. I also have the Susan G. Komen credit card that does the exact same thing. And the approval chances for these two cards are pretty high, even if you don't have a long credit history or a high credit score. They give you a decent credit line, and it's a really great card, and I'll definitely recommend this card for people who do not have a high credit score. Now let's move on to some of the other credit cards that you can apply for if you have a high credit score. Now we have the Chase Sapphire Preferred. As you can hear, this credit card is metal, and it's a really great credit card. Not just the look, but the feel and the material that this card is made out of. So I would recommend this credit card if you're looking for a credit card that you're trying to churn with. This credit card offers a really high sign-up bonus. It's offering 80,000 points when you first spend $4,000 in the first 3 months. 8,000 points is equivalent to $800 or $1,000 if you use it for travel purposes. If you have this card, all Chase points are worth 1.5 times the miles worth for traveling. So you can get $800 cash or $1,000 for traveling. On top of it, this card does not just have a great sign-up bonus, but it also has a lot of other perks. This card will also give you a $50 statement for your groceries in your first year. If you spend $50 in groceries on your first year, they'll put $50 towards your statement. Unfortunately, this card does have an annual fee at $95 a year, except it does offer other great perks, such as 2% cash back at restaurants and 2% cash back on traveling. So if you think about with the 25% higher in points redemption, you are honestly getting 2.5% cash back on restaurants and 2.5% cash back on traveling. If you're someone who orders out a lot like I do, this card is also really great as it also gives you DoorDash pass for a whole year. And after that, they'll give you a 50% off DoorDash pass, which is really good because DoorDash pass offers you free delivery and a cheaper fee. I mean, just hear the sound of this card, you know, it's amazing. It's a metal credit card and it's a really cool and great card. Even though I do have this credit card in front of me, it does have my name on it. This credit card is not active as I downgraded this credit card to the Chase Freedom Flex, which I showed you in my previous video. If you want to check out all my credit cards, feel free to check out my previous video as I have over 15 total cards. Now let's move on to the credit cards that I believe you should have in your wallet or purse or just in your pockets, but credit cards that you need to use every day and credit cards that will be useful wherever and whenever you go out. I'll be mentioning three different credit cards and all of these credit cards has no annual fee. However, they do have a foreign transaction fee. And the first one that we'll be talking about is the Citi Double Cashback credit card. And the reason why this credit card is so good is because they'll give you 1% cash back as you make a purchase. And they'll also give you 1% cash back when you pay off your balance, when you pay off your statement. So that's getting a total of 2% cash back. Imagine just getting 2% cash back on all of your purchases, or think about just getting a 2% off all of your purchases. There's no limit to this card, so feel free to spend as much and as less as you like. Getting 2% cash back on any credit card is really amazing, and that's why this one, however, does not have a sign-up bonus. This next credit card is probably one of my favorite cards, except I have yet to apply for it. It is the Chase Freedom Unlimited. So this credit card offers you 1.5% cash back on all purchases, 3% cash back on restaurants and drugstores, and 5% cash back if you book a flight or book a hotel through the Chase portal. And on top of that, if you spend $500 in your first 3 months, they'll give you $150 sign up bonus, which is amazing. And that's really amazing as this card is already really great with all the cash back that they're offering. And getting the sign up bonus on top of that is just a cherry on top of whatever people say it is. As mentioned earlier, this card does not have any annual fee. However, it does have a foreign transaction fee, which does suck if you do travel with this card. The last and final card that I believe everyone should have in their wallet is the Discover It Cash Rewards card. The reason why everyone should have this in their wallet is because this credit card offers you 1% cash back on all of your purchases. They also have 5% rotating category. For example, this quarter's rotating categories are gas station, streaming services, and wholesale club, while next quarter's rotating category is restaurants and PayPal. And usually at the end of the year, the rotating category is Walmart, Amazon, and Target. So you can get 5% cash back when it is that specific rotating category. This card doesn't have an annual fee. And this card is also really good because, as mentioned earlier, similar to Discover Secure card, this card also gives you double cash back at the end of your first year. So as the example that I gave earlier, if you earn $150 in cash back in your first year, they'll double that. And now you have a total of $300. Thank you for watching. I hope you apply to some of the credit cards that I share with you in this video. And before we close this video or go to the next video, please hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you.